Okay, this video is about sigmatropic rearrangements, which involve migration of a sigma bond around a system like this. Now, in a sigmatropic rearrangement, overall, there's no change in the number of sigma or pi bonds. And so we need to look for structural features within the molecule on the left versus the molecule on the right to see which side the equilibrium may favor. But firstly, how do we name these reactions? Well, if we follow the curly arrows here from that through to the product, we can see that the bond is being broken here and it's being formed here. So we can see that there's sort of two halves to the molecule. The first half, if we number that like so, we see that there's three atoms in that contiguous set of atoms that make up the ring at the transition state. And similarly, there's three atoms on this side. And so there's three atoms on each side of the sigma bond that's being formed and the sigma bond that's broken. And so we call that a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. Now, it's important to note that this methyl group here doesn't get counted in the numbering because although it's attached to this group here, it's not part of the chain that's within the ring that forms the transition state. So it's not part of the contiguous set of atoms that are undergoing the reaction and involved in the transition state of this reaction. Okay, so that particular reaction is called a Cope rearrangement. And how do we predict which side the equilibrium favors? Well, it favors this compound because it has more substituted double bond. So it's normally favorable for double bonds to have more alkyl and less hydrogen substituents. This molecule has a mono-substituted alkene here and a mono-substituted alkene here. So there's three hydrogens and one alkyl group, three hydrogens and one alkyl group. Whereas over here we have a di-substituted alkene and a mono-substituted alkene. So this molecule is more stable because we have one alkene with extra substitution. And so this will be the major component at equilibrium and this will be the minor. Okay, let's look at this example here. So once again, curly arrows, we can show this hard drive migrating, move these pi electrons around the ring, and we get to our product. Once again, there's the sigma bond that's breaking. Here's the sigma bond that is forming. And so there it is there that's forming. So on one side, the group that is migrating is only one atom in size. Whereas on the other side, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 contiguous atoms that are forming up the chain that is involved in the sigma bond that's breaking and the sigma bond that's forming. If we had other substituents here, they wouldn't get counted. We just look at the atoms in that chain that is part of the transition state. So this is a 1,5 sigmatropic rearrangement. Okay, and it's a hydrogen that's moving, so we could also call it a 1,5 hydride shift. Now, where does the equilibrium lie for this compound and for this reaction? Once again, it lies towards the right-hand side if we are assuming that the R group is some kind of alkyl group, like a methyl group or and so on. Because here we've got a more highly substituted double bond than we have in this molecule. We've got two disubstituted, whereas here we've got a trisubstituted and a disubstituted. Okay, so an overall key concept amongst these sorts of rearrangements is that the more substituted alkene are favored. And so we can use that general rule to predict which side of the equilibrium will be favored. Okay, so that's the Cope rearrangement, which is a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement and a 1,5 hydride shift. A very important type of sigmatropic rearrangement is the Claisen rearrangement. So here's the simplest case. This involves a vinyl allyl ether. So a vinyl group is where we have an alkene directly attached to something, and an allyl group is where we have a carbon CH2 and then a double bond, so that's an allyl group. And the curly arrows can be drawn like this to show how the product forms. There's the bond that's breaking, there's the bond that's formed, so there's where it's going to form there. So once again, if we number one side versus the other, there's three atoms on one half of this transition state and three atoms on the other, so this is also a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. This one lies over towards the right hand side because carbonyl groups are particularly strong functional groups, so particularly energetically favorable. So CO double bonds are particularly strong. So CO double bonds are very strong. And so therefore this lies over towards the right hand side where we have that carbonyl group. A particular example of Claisen rearrangement that is really important is the rearrangement of phenyl allyl ethers. So this is where we have a benzene ring connected to an allyl group through an oxygen atom. So this can undergo exactly the same sort of mechanism. Electrons moving around in a circle like this. We've got the new bond being formed here, the old bond being broken there. So this is also a 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement. However, the product has this ketone in a very special arrangement. So this is actually, you could think of this as being not a good thing because we're losing aromaticity of this benzene ring, but it's somewhat made up for by the fact that carbonyl groups are particularly strong. The Claisen rearrangement for these sorts of compounds doesn't stop there because we know that ketones are, they can tautomerize to an enol form, and there's always going to be that possibility of enol keto tautomerism. So that's the keto form. And this is an enol form. However, it's a very special enol form. It's a phenol. And phenols benefit from aromaticity, and so this is going to be the major product by far at equilibrium between these two. So overall, the Claisen rearrangement of a phenyl allyl ether goes to give this initially, but you don't see that because it tautomerizes to give the ortho allyl phenol. Tautomerizes. Okay, so that's sigmatropic rearrangements, how to number them, and a couple of most important invariants. The Cope rearrangement, 3,3 sigmatropic rearrangement, including oxygen, which is called the Claisen rearrangement, and 1,5 hydride shifts, which are particularly important in cyclopentadienes.